Hey guys, what's happening? And welcome to another episode of Any Metal Viking with me, your host Viking. Today I'm going to be reviewing an album which I have been waiting for a very long time, which is since the end of last year when it was announced. Not necessarily the release date, but when the album was coming out this year. So I've been pretty much waiting since the end of last year, and when it was announced a few months ago that it would be released, has been released this previous weekend, I was literally counting down the days until this album released. So without any further ado, let us get into this. Okay, so this album is Antihero, and it is performed, composed, and produced by Zardonic, who is signed to E1 Entertainment USA. This is a record label that hosts names such as Sean Kingston and many other popular artists. Basically, yes, this album is 26 tracks long, and for any lover of music, that is definitely a lot of tracks, and is definitely something that, when is put in the sense of an overall project, is definitely something worth listening to and will definitely make music fans very happy, especially since it's not like an EP, which nowadays usually consists of 5 or 6 tracks at the most and leaves the listener a bit empty and wanting more. So yeah, so basically this album is 26 tracks long. It consists of 2 discs. The first disc is basically, it's the original album with the original songs, the original mixes. Then the second disc is instrumental versions of some of the songs, and then we have remixes by well-known DJs from different genres. So we have industrial DJs such as Voicians making an appearance for the remix. We have Heavy Grinder. We have Rusty K, a local South African drum and bass duo, Counter-Strike. There's a whole bunch of names that have remixed these songs. And yeah, basically what I'd like to say is that this album is basically a breath of fresh air, not just for the electronic music scene, but also the metal scene. Now, for those of you who do not know, for those of you who watch my channel and are mainstream music listeners, the current trend in metal music at this point in time is deathcore. And that is usually bands such as Suicide Silence, Betraying the Martyrs, Whitechapel, All Shall Perish, and a whole bunch of other names, too many to list. So yeah, basically deathcore right now at the moment is the trendiest kind of metal, and is the metal that a lot of people my age, younger, and maybe a couple of years older than me listen to an awful lot. Basically, so now the deathcore genre is, I wouldn't say it's dying, I'd just say if people are starting to lose interest. It is unfortunately getting a little bit repetitive. Very few bands are trying to experiment with the genre and push it to maybe something more, whatever, but that's not to say that these bands are bad, etc., but basically the genre is kind of taking a bit of dive in listeners. So Zardonic here, as I said, he is like a breath of fresh air to the metal scene, not just the electronic music scene. So basically, before Zardonic, we've had a lot of electronic metal acts in the form of industrial music. We have industrial music, electro rock, electro metal, etc. And these artists come in the form of Cell Dweller, Blue Stully, Voicians, Combi Christ, Skinny Puppy, Nine Inch Nails, all these artists, and Ministry as well. Now these are all artists who are actually very well known, and I'm pretty sure for even for some mainstream music lovers that your parents or older siblings might or might not have played some popular tracks that have actually been put out there on top rock charts over the past couple of decades, etc., since the genre's creation. Zardonic, a lot of people tend to label him as industrial, or EDM lovers will either, like most EDM lovers, label him as EDM or hard dance or neurofunk, etc. But Zardonic doesn't sound like any of these genres. Zardonic, he even stated at first and labeled himself at first bass metal. I do not know whether he still likes to be called by that term or be labeled as bass metal, etc. But bass metal basically means is Zardonic is very much influenced by hardcore drum and bass music and metal music, mainly death metal and black metal. And this is very evident in his style. Basically, with this album, as I said, 26 tracks. So with the original tracks, we have a lot of mainly metal orientated tracks, but we do have one or two tracks that lean to a bit of the dubstep and a little bit of his traditional drum and bass signature sound. These tracks come in the form of Crush It, which is very much his a vulgar display of bass kind of sound, in which he went down the drum and bass route, and Override, which experiments a little bit with dubstep, but not the Skrillex kind of style, because Zardonic has made it very clear that he doesn't like dubstep, but that's not to say that he hasn't experimented with it before, as we've seen in some of his past works. So, yeah, basically this album is sheer brutality, and it should be. This is something that takes the energy and the vibe of metal music and incorporates it into very much hardcore electronic music. This style of music is harder and heavier than past electronic music artists. A lot of people say maybe Ministry is heavier than Zardonic, which I'm not saying they probably aren't. I haven't listened to much of Ministry's stuff. To be quite honest with you guys, I've only listened to one track of theirs, and that was Bad Blood off of the Matrix soundtrack. But to compare Zardonic to Ministry, I don't think seems very fair, or I don't think you can even compare them. Ministry have a totally different sound. While they Ministry do have some kind of a heavy bass sound, it's not that bass sound that we know and hear in EDM music or any of the EDM genres and subgenres. It's not that kind of electronic beat. It's Ministry's beats sound like something that literally is so heavy with the bass that it will blow your speaker if you turn it too loud. That is, it's more emphasis on the beats. Whereas Zardonic has a healthy balance between the electronic beat and the electric guitar style of his music. So basically, yeah, as I was saying with this album, sheer brutality, like metal should be. It takes the elements of both genres and mashes them together, and in a superb way. Listening to this album, like as I've said before in one of my earlier videos, when I listen to music, since I am an aspiring concept artist, video game designer, etc., when I listen to music, I like to listen to music that actually helps me come up with ideas, reminds me of something, helps me to focus on a specific project that I'm maybe working on. And in the case of Zardonic, I'd have to say, especially with the case of this album, since Zardonic has now actually found his signature sound, I thought of many things while listening to this album, mainly things, a bit of cyberpunk, so Ghost in the Shell or Appleseed Ex Machina, or any of Appleseed's for that matter, the Terminator, Aliens, anything cyberpunk, and it does sound fit that it should be on any of those hit films or series soundtracks. It's as I said, it's heavy and it's brutal. Also, with this album, I noticed that Zardonic has basically made tracks that could rival that of, for lack of a better description, pure metal bands, bands that use the drums and the guitars, etc. Zardonic, these tracks on this album prove that actually Zardonic could actually be a headlining act at any metal festival, whether it be Knotfest, and well, I only know some of the names of previously now cancelled, no longer existing festivals, etc. But that's mainly because South Africa doesn't really have any festivals apart from Ramfest and Opikopi. So forgive me for not knowing a lot of the major American and other overseas tours. Oh right, Sonosphere. So anyway, yes, this album has a lot of variety in it, but while having a lot of variety, Zardonic, the way he structured the track list and even the way he mixed it, the whole album fits into one. It eases into the next track, into the next track, and that is a good thing. And this is an album that will definitely get your adrenaline going. It will definitely make you want to literally start moshing by yourself. It is one of those albums that is just filled with so much energy, and you can tell a lot of work went into this album, and it's absolutely fantastic. Second disc, as I said, contains instrumentals of some of the tracks and remixes. Now, I haven't listened to some of the full remixes of some of the others. That's mainly because some of the remixes of genres I'm not particularly into. And the stuff I will try when I eventually get my own actual digital or physical copy. I will actually try to listen to the full tracks. But from the majority of the remixes, these guys who remixed Zardonic's tracks, they, although adding their own sound, their traditional or signature sound to these songs, they still managed to maintain the energy and the sound of Zardonic in these tracks, especially with Heavy Grinder's remix of Pure Power. And even though Voicians took the Antihero, the album title track, and made it into a bit more of his signature ambient trance industrial rock kind of sound, it still maintained that Zardonic brutalness, only on a more melodic scale. Not to say Zardonic's tracks aren't melodic on their own, but this is more ambient, melodic, at the same time brutal, whereas Zardonic's original version of the track is just brutal. So, yeah, basically, Zardonic has done a very good job in composing these songs and in producing this album. The fact that it's taken 10 years of a career as Zardonic to come this far and actually make it to such a level is actually amazing. It just goes to show that hard work and perseverance, with hard work and perseverance, you can actually achieve your goals and your dreams, etc. So I think this is also something that musicians or even music fans need to aspire to. I mean, not only do we have Zardonic, and I've mentioned this before in previous videos, we also have Sophia of Season of Ghosts, and a lot of other bands and artists. Dead by April, Escape the Day, these are all hardworking musicians, and it's sometimes, not with all of these artists, but sometimes it's such a shame to see how they go by underrated or go by unnoticed. And yeah, it's just sad. But Zardonic, hopefully, will hopefully break this cycle of repetitiveness in some music genres and hopefully start something new. That is what I very much believe. Zardonic and a couple of other artists who I'm not going to delve very much into since this video is about Zardonic. Zardonic, these guys are bringing new things to the table and new ideas and are actually pushing the boundaries of metal music and electronic music in general, and we need artists such as this to just create new stuff and really bring us back to the reason why we love music, and also to unite people of different genres together, fans of different genres together. And I think that is something that is worth striving for. So overall, this album, I would have to rate it. I have to admit, I tried to be as non-biased as possible. I'd have to rate this album a 98 out of 100. Main reason being is because nothing is perfect, so I can't give it 100 out of 100, that'll be too biased. So 98 out of 100. This is an album definitely worth owning. I suggest you guys go check out Zardonic's Facebook page, his Twitter page, his YouTube account, and his SoundCloud. Go follow him, go check out his music. This guy is absolutely talented, and if you are a fan of EDM music, any kind of EDM music, if you are a fan of metal music, industrial metal, go and check out this album. This is definitely one of the best albums of the year, and it's literally an album worth owning, and it's perfect for any lover of the genres I have just mentioned. And that concludes this review for today. I'm Viking, and until next time, have a kick-ass day.